Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable. Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry, or FICCI, among the largest and oldest APEC business associations in India, organized its flagship 92nd annual convention and AGM in New Delhi. With the theme, India, Roadmap to a $5 trillion economy, the event saw the presence of leading voices of government, captains of industry, diplomats and global Indians among others. In his inaugural session, Sandeep Somani, President FICCI, spoke about the importance of strengthening the partnership between the government and industry.
At the 73rd annual session of FICCI in the year 2000, late Prime Minister Shri Atal Bihari Ji, Vajpayee Ji, had laid special emphasis on the need to strengthen the partnership between government and industry. India has witnessed good economic growth since then, and especially in the last few years, it has been the fastest growing economy in the world. It is only the venerable partnership between the industry and government that can bring to 7-8% and even higher in the coming quarters and years to achieve the target set by the Prime Minister of making India a 5 trillion economy soon. This is why we decided to dwell at length during this year's annual session on the agenda India, Roadmap to a 5 trillion economy. Becoming a 5 trillion economy is a given. The question is only how soon. The government led by PM Modi has already turned the downturn in the economy into an opportunity to deepen the reforms by getting into the critical areas like labor laws, besides the added focus on fiscal and monetary policy measures. If IBC, GST and RERA are the reforms implemented by the government in its first year, in its first term, that have laid a solid roadmap for the improving the business environment in the country, India has moved up 79 places in the ease of doing business rankings from 142nd in 2014 to 63rd in 2019, and is well poised to break into the top 25 in the next few years.
The convention also hosted Minister for Railways, Commerce and Industry, Piyush Goyal, who also stressed on the need for a sustained dialogue between government and industry. In his address, he outlined how this process has already been set in motion.
I compliment FICCI for having served India and Indian industry for over 90 years now. Thank you very much for all the good work that has happened in terms of highlighting and, of course, raising issues from time to time which truly matter for India and Indian industry. We also try on our end, if we get the concerns and issues in advance, to have all the different ministries in the room so that we can look at some faster outcomes. And I believe that that will be the way forward for us to address issues which ultimately don't concern one group or company, but I'm sure will concern all of you in this room. Because as you're aware, and as I've repeatedly said on many interactions at FICCI, this government does not believe in solving issues individually for a company. I assure you that every one of the issues that are flagged off will be taken to its logical end. Where I'm not able to solve it, I'll share with you what the issues are, what the concerns are. But we'll certainly give it every possible shot that's possible to make that happen. Prime Minister from day one has set this ground rule that every decision his government will take will ensure that the impact of that decision will be good for the people of India, particularly the people at the bottom of the pyramid, and will ensure that Indian trade, Indian industry, Indian business does not get damaged or harmed by any action of the government. If we are willing to listen and talk to each other, I commit myself on this very august occasion when FICCI is celebrating its annual general meeting and the change of baton, I commit myself to being a part of this journey to $5 trillion with you.
Chief Economist at IMF, Geeta Gopinath, shared some interesting insights on what ails the Indian economy, how a turnaround can be brought about, and the current outlook on the global economy in a chat with Harshpati Singhania, past President FICCI.
I don't want to get into statistics, but we've seen lots of numbers coming out recently from the RBI estimates of growth. IMF itself had its own growth estimate, which I read somewhere that you are probably going to review in January about India. Regrettably, a lot of these numbers have been on a downward slide. So the question really is, what can we do in India? Some specific 2-3 broad thoughts on what can we do to bring back growth. Everybody talks about their issues being with demand, issues in terms of less investment. We've had a backdrop of moderate or low inflation. So within this, how would you see this and how do we take this forward?
You know, one statistic that you have out there is a measure of business sentiment. And you see business sentiment, you know, go back to 2014-15, it kind of holds up quite well into 2019. And in October, November is when you see this drop in business sentiment. So that, those are movements that are hard to predict, and that was an important part. Now, more deeply speaking, what are the areas that are a source of the issue? One is with respect to the, you know, financing. The finance sector, with the banks and the non-bank financial corporations, the stress associated with them is more persistent and is deeper than many projected. So second, of course, is rural income. And rural income growth is very important. You know, government has taken steps in terms of providing more income to farmers. But that's not going to permanently solve the problem. There is a big need for raising productivity in agriculture in India, and that's an important factor. And third, I would keep in mind the fact that for India, macro stability is very important, which means stability on the fiscal front. A clear sense of keeping to the target of fiscal consolidation is very important. Now, that would require both increasing revenue mobilization and also rationalizing expenditures.
The other question which people have been asking in India is that, is this slowdown currently, is this structural or is this cyclical?
What we're seeing right now is weakness in investment. And if there is prolonged weakness in investment, that by construction affects potential growth because there's lower capital in the economy. And so then that becomes part structural going forward. And of course, there's no reason for it to stay there and for the foreseeable future. You would expect that there would be a recovery and coming back to trend growth. But again, a cycle where you end up with very weak investment for a very long period of time ends up being structural, which is why I mentioned the need for fixing the problems on the financing side and for increasing, you know, positive sentiment towards investment.
One feeling that several people have in India is that there is a certain degree of regulatory overzealousness. So part of the issues that banks or financial institutions face in terms of credit terms, et cetera, come from those regulations. Now, they may be well-founded. The question is, are they, at this point in time, the best thing to do?
In the slowdown, regulatory uncertainty has played a role, and so that's another factor that needs to be addressed. I think that, you know, it's important for India to undertake reforms, but to be able to do this with greater clarity and greater certainty would help. I mean, this also applies to a good reform like the GST, which is important, has been very important for helping formalize the Indian economy. But again, there certainly needs more to be done on, you know, what the rules are, to be able to improve compliance, what the rates are going to be. I mean, all of that makes a big difference.
What are some of the major global trends, as in the trade wars, partly that seems to be resolved? I don't know if it's resolved, but there seems to be some discussion between China and the U.S. in particular. But this entire trade issue and increasingly countries reverting to some degree of protectionism, how do you think this is likely to play out, and how does this impact India? Do you believe there are opportunities for us from India, or do you believe it poses barriers in terms of global supply chains that you just talked about?
What we're seeing in the last couple of months towards the end of this year is what looks like tentative signs of stabilization. So, you know, while through 2019 the services sector was holding up across the globe for many countries, there was a concern of whether the weakness in manufacturing would then translate into weakness in services. Now, you saw some of that for a country like Germany, which is a major manufacturing exporter. You definitely saw that. But more generally, services has held up. So, to say something on a positive note, which is that we're seeing signs of stabilization. Some of the big concerns that were there in 2019, like whether the tariffs would come about on December 15th, that has not happened. A phase one deal has been announced. Now we have to still look at the details of what the phase one deal looks like and how durable it's going to be. But there seems like there's some reduction in uncertainty on that particular front. But that said, you know, there are still many downside risks. So the uncertainty could move from trade tensions with one country to another country. They could reemerge. There could be more on the technology side. So many factors still remain. But, you know, again, to leave on a little positive note is we've seen some tentative signs of stabilization with some possible improvements in 2020.
Dr. Geeta Gopinath, on that positive note, I'm afraid we run out of time. Thank you very much for your perspective and remarks at this FICCI AGM session. Thank you very much, Dr. Gopinath. Pleasure.
FICCI's 92nd Annual Convention was attended by a host of important government voices, business luminaries and influential global Indians. Founder and chairman of Vedanta Resources, Anil Agarwal was one such global Indian voice who made his presence felt at the event in a fireside chat moderated by FICCI President Sandeep Somani. The chat was generously laced with anecdotes from the business leader's own life as he tried to inspire the audience to reach for greater heights.
थोड़ा आपका business के बारे में बात करें.
जी.
What is the method in your madness? Kai consultants have a certain way in which businesses should be grown. There's competitive advantages of nations, there's competitive strategy. Aapka dimag kaise chalta hai? Aap jo acquisitions karte hain, kis basis pe karte hain? Aap power mein hain, aap oil mein hain, aap gas mein hain, aap copper mein hain, aap aluminium mein hain. Chalu aap cable se kare the, uske pehle scrap deal karte the. To aap kaise decide karte hain ki kis business mein jana hai, kis mein nahi jana hai?
हरदम इच्छा थी कि केबल की कंपनी लें, तो केबल कंपनी में भी हम लोग की शमशेर स्टर्लिंग थी, वो केबल कंपनी ली. बट वो केबल कंपनी चलाई 8-9 साल तक. उसमें लगा कि केबल में इतना फायदा नहीं है, उसके जो रॉ मटेरियल है उसमें बहुत अच्छा है. तो कॉपर अल्यूमिनियम जो लगता था, टेलीफोन केबल में काम दिया. उस समय टेलीफोन केबल गवर्नमेंट से कंट्रोल थी, हिंदुस्तान केबल ही केबल कंपनी टेलीफोन केबल बना सकती थी. तो वी गेट इनटू दैट. तो करते करते 3-4 गवर्नमेंट के ऑक्शन हुए, तीनों कंपनियां मिली, हिंदुस्तान सिंह भी मिली, और रिस्क लेते चले गए. रिस्क तो मैं आपको सबसे एक ही वादा चाहता हूं, रिस्क लेना क्या है इस लाइफ में. अगर रिस्क नहीं लेंगे तो फिर काम आगे कैसे बढ़ेगा. और टीम बनाना, लोगों पर ट्रस्ट करना, जो भी होगा ट्रस्ट करेंगे. जो हिंदुस्तान में पोटेंशियल है हिंदुस्तानी के लिए, और कहीं हो ही नहीं सकती है. प्यार से मोहब्बत से हम आगे बढ़ते हैं, और हिंदुस्तान में तो आज कुछ है ही नहीं, बेस लेवल पे चल रहे हैं. और ये गवर्नमेंट ऐसी आई है जो क्लीन स्लेट दे रही है. हम लोगों की बहुत तकलीफें हुई 3-4 साल में, क्योंकि हमारी हम तैयार नहीं थे ऐसी पोजीशन से, ऐसी बात से. गवर्नमेंट भी समझी है, हम भी समझे, जो मेरे को समझ में आता है. आने वाले दिनों में मेरे को लगता है कि बहुत अच्छी अपॉर्चुनिटी है अपन लोगों को आगे बढ़ने के लिए. मैं भी अपना बिजनेस देख रहा हूँ, मैंने भी तेल की कंपनी ली. अपने में तमन्ना ऐसी है, जिगर ऐसा है. तो तेल की कंपनी हमने सेसा गोवा ली, वो जापानीज कंपनी मित्सुई से ली थी. तो उन्होंने कहा कि इसमें आयरन ओर नहीं रहा, हमने लार्जेस्ट आयरन ओर निकला अपने को अपने में क्या है एक लगन है एक पैशन है एक जुनून है और आप लोगों में जुनून है अपने में और है क्या और इस लाइफ में अगर पागलपन नहीं रहेगा तो क्या रहेगा प्यार किया तो पागल होके किया काम किया तो पागल होके किया
आप जब बहुत छोटी मूल लेके निकले बिहार से और बॉम्बे चले गए और फिर बॉम्बे से आप 22 साल पहले लंदन चले गए तो आपको कभी डर नहीं लगा
हाँ मैं दिल की बात बताऊंगा आपको एक हैंडल तो पकड़ना ही पड़ेगा एक सहारा तो मानना ही पड़ेगा एक हैंडल पकड़िए चाहे वो भगवान का हो चाहे माँ बाप का हो चाहे वो मिथ हो चाहे एक आपको एक तो पकड़ना पड़ेगा वो बैठा है वो बैठा है मेरी माँ बैठी है मेरा कृष्ण बैठा है और उस हैंडल से बहुत ताकत मिलती है 10 हैंडल मत पकड़ो एक हैंडल तो पकड़ो और वो हैंडल मैं पकड़ता हूँ और उससे बहुत ताकत मिलती है
ये बताइए जब आप लंदन मूव कर गए उसके बाद आपने बहुत सिग्निफिकेंट ग्रोथ करी और लंदन मूव करने के बाद आपका क्या एक्सपीरियंस रहा
तो वहाँ लंदन में गए और मैंने देखा कि ये अपने में हमने आप देखो मैंने बोर्ड बनाई आप बोर्ड आप मेरी देखोगे लंदन ने कंपनी बनाई एक उसका बोर्ड बनाया बोर्ड बना के उसमें डेविड गौर बूथ KPMG का चेयरमैन मिस्टर चिदम्बरम अपनी कंपनी को यहां से डीलिस्ट कराया और लंदन में लिस्ट कराया $2 बिलियन में एक वो जुनून चाहिए एक बात चाहिए हमारे राजस्थान में बोलते हैं ना बात को और भाटे को जैसे बैठा वैसे बैठ जाता है हमने वहां पे $40 बिलियन रेज किए और मेरे को बहुत अपॉर्चुनिटी आई थी बाहर में पैसा लगाने की मेरा दिल नहीं करता था लगता था सारे जहां से अच्छा हिंदुस्तान हमारा
अच्छा ये बताइए अनिल जी कि गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया से जो इनपुट आ रहे हैं टू फाइनेंस देयर फिस्कल डेफिसिट टू पुट मोर मनी इन रूरल प्रोग्राम्स दे विल हैव टू स्टेप अप द डिसइन्वेस्टमेंट फॉर द नेक्स्ट फ्यू ईयर्स 1,15,000 या 20,000 करोड़ का तो इस साल का टारगेट है तो आपका क्या ओपिनियन है ऑन डिसइन्वेस्टमेंट और फिर आप तो बहुत बड़े प्लेयर होंगे इसमें NCLT में तो आपने ऑलरेडी काम चालू कर दिया एक कंपनी आपने एक्वायर भी कर ली तो व्हाट इज योर विजन फॉर ऑल दिस
मैं तो बहुत छोटा हूं लेकिन आने वाले दिनों में बहुत अपॉर्चुनिटी है मेरे हिसाब से थोड़ा रिस्क लेंगे तो मेरे हिसाब से तीन चीजें जरूर होंगी एक तो जैसे गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इवन 87% बैंक और पब्लिक सेक्टर होल्ड करती है ऑन एवरेज इफ दे ब्रिंग इट डाउन टू 50% फ्रॉम 87% दे विल हैव $1 ट्रिलियन एंड दैट $1 ट्रिलियन कैन गो एनीवेयर तो इट इज ह्यूज अपॉर्चुनिटी आई एम नॉट इन फेवर दैट सब कंपनियां प्राइवेटाइज ही कर दी जाएं बिकॉज गवर्नमेंट के CEO बहुत अच्छे हैं सारी होल वर्ल्ड रन विद द कॉर्पोरेटाइज बेसिस सो पब्लिक शुड be the shareholder government should not be in a business number two natural resource is a very very big thing I encourage all of you please look at that that area whether is a iron ore bauxite coal gold silver India has only done 2.5% with the world average of 30% So much of opportunity is coming. A small player can do, but government is reforming to do the junior mining, to do this exploration. If you do the exploration, you can sell that that asset. If you develop the mine, big miners will take it. If you develop your own mine, that will also work apart from the logistic. Then you, even if you look at the aluminium can have 10% of business in China is related to aluminium. Everything being converted in aluminium, India has nowhere near that 350 product can be developed from aluminium. Somebody want to start. Quality is very important. The whole world is looking for the collaboration. Technology is a great opportunity in copper, aluminium, zinc, lead, silver.
अच्छा एक चीज आपको पूछूंगा I know you have a very deep interest in philanthropy और आप giving back to society आप बहुत काम करते हैं कुछ अपनी यूनिवर्सिटी के बारे में बताएंगे जो आप इंडिया में लगाने जा रहे हैं, जिसका आई एम टोल्ड कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर जब खत्म होगी करीब बिलियन डॉलर से ऊपर होगा।
हमको बहुत इच्छा है कि देश के बच्चे जो हैं उन्होंने क्या गुनाह किया है जो उनको भोजन नहीं मिले, उनको पढ़ाई नहीं हो, तो उनकी हेल्थ चेकअप नहीं हो, तो हम लोगों ने वो 1200 नंदघर बनाए। मोदी जी ने कहा उनका नाम नंदघर कर देते हैं, आंगनबाड़ी अच्छा नहीं लग रहा है, तो नंदघर कर दिया उनका नाम। तो नंदघर में सुबह वो बच्चे आते हैं तो बच्चों को टीवी से सब टेक्नोलॉजी। सेम थिंग वी थॉट दैट बिलियंस ऑफ डॉलर गोइंग फॉर एजुकेशन, why can't we create another Harvard in India? A little bit Indianized, people love to come here. So we thought ki, aur humne dekha ki 15% faculty in the world is Indian and they all want to come to India. So how come, why can't we create another education city like a Boston and give our children a 25% education? So that was the thought we are working on, but I need all of your support.
Thank you ji. May I ask our senior VP to give a vote of thanks?
So, Anil ji, I think a very, very heartfelt thank you to you. You, not only your presence, but your candid sharing of thoughts, the depth of your knowledge, the power of your messaging. I think you are our Dalai Lama of business. I cannot thank you enough. We all go back energized. I think we started today or a lot of the, you know, things with the worry about the business and the environment and the economy. You have energized us entirely, so we leave this year on a very good note and we'll start the new year with your thoughts in mind. So thank you so much, Anil.
Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.